Greetings, this is Alaya from the Lighter Mansions of the Pleiades. Alaya is my Pleiadian name and has nothing to do with any Earth language. A part of my soul is currently incarnated on Earth in a physical body. Since I came to Earth, I am helping Earth people to develop spirituality by activating the love in their heart. I gave many seminars and healings, and in 2007, I started to make more videos for YouTube. Please be aware, spirituality has nothing to do with religions. Spirituality is the ability to be in tune with the existence and has nothing to do with superstitions, doctrines, bigotry, oppression, and exploitation of Earth humans. Being spiritual means to use the light of love. Please note, you can find me correctly on the internet only on my own YouTube channel, 777 Alaya. I'm nowhere else on the internet and I do not write on any other web pages. Informations about me can be found if you activate love in your heart and ask the existence, light beings, spiritual extraterrestrials or your higher self. As I said in all my videos, the meaning of life is to have love in the heart and to develop spiritually. Love is the solution for everything, because it is the supreme power of the existence. Love is the center of cosmic consciousness that is called God on Earth. Only with the power of love we can eliminate the negativity on this planet and create a planet of free and happy people. The existence has a training system of cause and effect. In that way a soul is developing. Everything is energy. All our thoughts, feelings and actions are creating an energy that creates our environment. When you create positive energies, you create a positive, free, healthy planet, without suffering, without violence and without natural disasters. When you create negative energy, you create a world full of hatred, arrogance, violence, madness, army, war, politicians, secret governments, religious fanatism, consumption insanity, earthquakes, floods, volcanic eruptions, and chaotic weather, contaminated food, smoking, and disease. Only when you are in harmony with the existence, when you are in harmony with love, you are living healthy. Extraterrestrial humans, spiritual masters, and beings of light from many thousands of star systems have always taught Earth humans of this knowledge. Many of those light workers are voluntarily incarnated on Earth to help Earth humans to live in love and to expand their consciousness. We light workers are acting as a channel for the cosmic light of the source, and we are transforming any negative energy. We are sending light and love energy to the entire planet so that all Earth humans use the power of spiritual light, the energy of love, and thus free the Earth from hatred, suffering and ignorance. For many years now, I make light work with other loving people and use energy places on the entire planet in order to strengthen our energy. In June 2011, I visited with 30 other light workers ancient temples in Greece, because all ancient temples were built on energy places. In ancient times, about 10,000 years ago, there were several groups of extraterrestrials who were operating at various places on Earth. All so-called gods of Earth's history were extraterrestrials. The ancient Earth humans have worshipped them as gods or angels because they did not understand their technology and knowledge. They saw the extraterrestrials flying with spaceships, but because they did not know what a spaceship is, they interpreted it with the words of the objects they knew. Artists were showing them either flying in chariots or were depicted with wings. In the European area, there was a group of extraterrestrials who had their base on Mount Olympus in Greece. Their leader Zeus had technology to use electromagnetic energy. Others like Poseidon had this technology too. Benevolent extraterrestrial humans had regular contacts with intelligent people in ancient times and tried to help them to develop intellectually. They were teaching them mathematics, astronomy, art, agricultural science, philosophy, and medicine. But after many centuries, Earth humans misunderstood a lot, and they changed many things with their own belief systems. These extraterrestrials had knowledge of the plan of creation, the transformation of DNA, and expansion of consciousness. They had a technological device, an energy stuff, with which they could transform the DNA of a human being to heal him and expand his consciousness. Later, Earth humans called this medical device God stuff or magic wand. In Greece, this stuff was called Kirikion, which means the stuff of teachers. In the Latin language, it is called Caduceus, and in ancient Egypt, the staff was called Ankh, the key of life. In many Egyptian wall reliefs and paintings, you can see extraterrestrial messengers who use this energy staff to heal people and to transform their consciousness. In India, you can see the extraterrestrial Shiva depicted with this staff. Extraterrestrial humans could heal with the staff of life. That is why it was known as a symbol of healing. Even today, it is used by doctors and pharmacies as a symbol of healing, even if they don't know the true origin of the symbol. The most famous messenger of extraterrestrials in Europe was Hermes. In Italy, he was called Mercury. And in Egypt, he was called Thoth. Hermes flew with his spaceship from place to place, so ancient artists depicted him with wings on his shoes. The helmet with wings on his head symbolizes his flying spaceship. In his hand, he is keeping the so-called staff of the gods, the staff of life. Even in modern times, extraterrestrials are showing the symbol of the staff of life in crop circle pictograms so that the Earth people remember it. This energy staff is a reflection of the creation plan that exists in every living being. It symbolizes many things at once. It shows that everything in existence is developing in a spiral form. The staff symbolizes the life path that moves in a spiral way. It symbolizes that with the use of cosmic energy, you can develop into higher dimensions. It symbolizes the transformation of primitive humans in celestial humans, if they can overcome the lower negative instincts and use the energy of love. It symbolizes the transformation of the DNA, which is also a spiral, and the development of the chakra system, which in ancient Sanskrit it is called Kundalini. Kundalini comes from Kundala, which means twisted or rolled. The Kundalini energy should develop only naturally, by developing the consciousness and by using the energy of love. If you want to awaken this energy force too early, without having the wisdom for it, you create a mental damage, then you make mistakes, and then you create negative karma, and you are blocking your development. The activation of this energy must happen naturally, at the right time. The spiral of the staff symbolizes how you develop along the life path upwards. The soul is living thousands of incarnations as gas, mineral, plant, animal and human to make experiences and to develop spiritually. The soul is having experiences with both polarities, male, female, positive and negative. If you have learned to use the frequency of love and not hatred, ego and arrogance, you have mastered the polarity of the lower dimensions and you can incarnate in higher dimensions. The higher dimensions are represented by the wings. In all my videos I say the meaning of life is the development of the heart and the consciousness. On earth the staff of life was also called the tree of life and was symbolically represented by artists as a tree with a man and a woman beside. In the last 2000 years, this picture was used by earth religions to program the earth humans with feelings of guilt and sin, so they should redeem themselves by paying money to the priests. But in truth, the staff of life symbolizes the principle of how to transform yourself with the cosmic energy of love and move to higher stages of evolution. If you get into the higher dimensions, you can use the cosmic energy of love in everything. In higher dimensions, we use the power of love not only in ourselves, but also for flying our ships. Our ships are made from the pure energy of love and can manifest themselves in any form. The extraterrestrial Hermes was a son of Zeus. Another son of Zeus was Apollo. Both were using the staff of life. The extraterrestrial Apollo had with an earth woman the son Asclepius, who lived in Greece. He passed his knowledge of the staff to Asclepius, that is why Asclepius became the most famous healer in ancient Greece. Asclepius built a large temple complex on a power place in Epidavros, where he healed thousands of people with the energy of the place and his own energy. It was an ancient spa resort with baths, restaurants, hotel rooms, treatment rooms and a theater. There's a lot of healing energy stored in this temple complex, and so I started my lightwork tour at this place. Here we cleansed ourselves with healing energy and we sent light energy around the planet. My space brothers observed us with telemeter discs here too. Telemeter discs are small remote controlled spacecrafts, which are like a spiritual camera. They can not only record images but also emotions and thoughts. I already said in my other videos that feelings and thoughts are energy. At night we went to Mount Pandeli near Athens, where we used the energy of the mountain to send light and love to earth. Here we made many orb pictures again, which we attracted with our love energy. As I said in my last video, orbs are consciousness from many different beings, from many dimensions. Thank you. Sometimes you can see even faces in the orbs. In this picture that I made in July 2011, you can see the face of the spiritual master Jesus. He and many other spiritual teachers were teaching earth humans how to become a master too, and none of those teachers wanted to be worshipped. His original teachings were about love, cosmic wisdom, reincarnation, and real spiritual development. It was not about being a fanatic or a slave of a religion. This was created later by priests and kings. The teachings of Jesus were only about using the love in the heart. He is just like me, a member of the Galactic Federation of Light, where thousands of benevolent extraterrestrial races are working together in coordination with the Source. The next day we went to the energy place called Delphi. The word Delphi comes from the Greek word delphini, which means dolphin. Dolphins are incarnated extraterrestrials from the star system Sirius. This place was called Delphi because it has a strong Sirian energy. They built a large temple complex here to utilize the energy of the mountain. In this temple complex, there were people who could use this energy to see into potential future lines. It was the most famous oracle site in ancient times. Next, we visited the ruins of a temple of Zeus on a mountain. This temple was built on an energy place too. Here we anchored a huge light ball that will send cosmic energy light forever to increase the awareness of the earth people. The next day we visited a temple in Sunyu, which was built to honor the extraterrestrial Poseidon. Like all ancient temples, this temple was built also on an energy place, so that the people who come here can use this energy. Here again, we send our love energy to Earth to transform all negative energies into positive energies, because thoughts and emotions are energy and create our reality and future. We are in a time where anybody on Earth must decide whether he wants to live for love and thereby develop further, or stay in a lower consciousness. Negative people who are against love, against the existence, remain in the lower dimensions of suffering until they have evolved. Many of them repeat this school for thousands of lives because they prefer hate instead of love. So be aware that if you make light work and send love, there are negative people who want to prevent this. These hateful people are influenced by negative entities, from the lower astral dimension and are used to attack lightworkers. Such people are those who are insulting me on the internet. They even claim to be spiritual, but in truth they are against the light and against love and want to confuse others. Many of them are incarnated reptilian draconians. This is an extraterrestrial race that is afraid of the light and hate loving humans. They are attacking lightworkers, and when you defend yourself, they will tell you that you are not spiritual. This is a very old trick of the dark side to make loving people weak and insecure. But the truth is that we lightworkers have the right and the duty to protect ourselves and others. If enough lightworkers continue to be a channel for the cosmic light of the source, we can help even these confused souls to evolve. The light will help them to realize one day that hatred only brings devastation, and only the energy of love leads to success, happiness and bliss. There is still too much hatred, destruction, disasters and suffering on this planet, and this energy creates an unpleasant future. It is time that all Earth humans use the spiritual power of true universal love to transform the current negative energies on Earth and create a bright future. Only with a higher energy you can change a low energy. The frequency of love is the highest energy and can transform all areas of life. The frequency of love can overcome all the problems on Earth, for it is the energy of the source, the energy of the consciousness called God. In my videos on my YouTube channel 777 Alaya, you can find everything you need to create a loving planet and develop your consciousness. Let us transform this planet into a place of peace and light, just like it is already the case on other planets. Be light, be love, be happy.